In 1857, community leaders in Chicago joined forces to open one of our legacy institutions, Merchant Savings. Their sound business practices enabled the bank to thrive at a time when others failed. With the outbreak of the Civil War, the policy of free banking became a disaster. Isaac Arnold, the founder of the Chicago Bank, led the drive for monetary reform, and Lincoln soon afterwards signed the National Currency Act of 1863 and the National Bank Act of 1864, creating the first government-secured national currency, the greenback dollar. After the war, reconciliation meant resumption of financial operations so that business and commerce could be reinvigorated. Northern and Southern bankers met in Richmond to create an institution that would fill this desperate need. They established the People's Bank of Virginia, but the South could no longer sustain its economy by growing cotton alone. A number of our predecessor banks were formed to fund the emerging textile industry. And in 1874, the NCNB legacy began in Charlotte with the founding of Commercial National Bank.